hand is okay. Opponent with Wandering Funeral. That's kind of weird. Not really what I was expecting. I'm gonna go with probably the Marsh Flats. In case I need to pathfinder or something, I'm gonna get a Plains. In case I don't, I'm just gonna get a Dual Land. Okay, so it looks like a control strategy. I'm probably just firing off a Scavenging Ooze here. It's just the less powerful card. And I obviously don't want to play Tarmogoyf because it's gonna die to a Bolt. And I also don't want to play Dark Confident because it's the best card against control. So you want to slow roll it as much as possible. Okay, so everyone predicted that the Scavenging Goose was no longer for this word, so no surprise there. Next turn, I think I'm happy to play a Tarmogoyf. Since now it doesn't die to Lightning Bolt anymore. It's gonna probably mate a Spellsnare or Monolith, but it's okay. This is probably Blood Moon. Sorry, Blue Moon. So I'm going to play a couple of basic land. So I'm gonna take a couple of basic land. Don't exactly know which kind of basic land do I want. Probably forest. Alright, Snapcaster Bolt me looks like. Oh, Snapcaster. Oh. Okay. Then I'm going to Path to Exile your Snapcaster. And my Tarmogoyf is going to survive. I chose to take a Plains now because I don't want to get two extra damages, and yeah, it was still fine. Right, Plains, I was not expecting that. Guess I'm going to attack and play. I know what to play in a round here. Let's just fire off with our confidence and see how it goes. It resolved. I'm going to just play a tap land and pass here. Afraid of a mass removal spell. Ooh. And I die. Sure. Playing this way was kinda safer because, you know, I could represent Path to Exile. Yeah, that's how my opponent made that play. It was a pretty smart from my opponent to let me play Path to Exile there. It's kind of nice. Alright, so what do we want? Pithy Needle stops the combo, but I don't really care, actually. This Pebble stops Snapcaster Mage, and they might care. Abzan Charm I definitely like because of stops the combo, and it's a draws card. Thrawn is fine. Collective Reality maybe is not good. Gonna board it out. Celestial Purge, I like. Yeah. Valorous Dance. Let's see what's not good. Arbor Decay looks not good. Not know about Mushroom Pools. Also, usually I board out one Scavenging Ooze against your Sky. Lingering Silence is fine. I think I want to board in the Spell Bombs because I want to smooth a little bit my curve. That gets a little bit too heavy. I guess Mushroom Pulse is good because it deals with the Resto. I might be fine in boarding out all the Oozes, honestly. Looks stupid to board in the new Spell Bomb and board out Ooze, but the thing is that Ooze really dies every time. Like, they probably have Bolt and Lightning Helix and Electrolyze. is just die, always dies. And I guess that's the same argument for they're confident, but the difference that if they're confident hits just once, like if you manage to untap with they're confident once, it's gonna be huge. If you untap with scavenging ooze, it's not gonna be huge. By the way, I think I know what I'm gonna cut. I'm gonna cut a couple of collective brutality. On one hand, they are fine because they are duress actually, but you know, 2 mana duress is not where you wanna be. So I'm gonna be just go like this. Playing first against just Kai Kiki Jiki. Yeah, this is great. Turn one discard spell, turn two confident. Gonna get a Godless Shrine. Can't wait for the new land. The new on top land. Okay, this is perfect. Wow, Voodoo Voodoos? What's up? Oh, I guess they're very way cheaper than the new one. Okay, so here, usually Snapcaster Mage, it's a card that you always discard. Which, I was about to say that Snapcaster Mage is always this card that you discard. But Spesner here is great because let my opponent, like, I'm gonna resolve the Dark Confident, my opponent is forced to play Path to Exile on it. Which is gonna give me the third land that I want. Yeah, I guess it's so much better. Like, yeah, you don't, there's Snapcaster Mage, it's very good, but like, the extra land here could be very, very relevant. Because that's like, I don't have a third land here. So, like, let's say I take a Snapcaster Mage and then put a Spell Snare. I can play Ooze and my opponent's going to probably Spell Snare it, but still, I'm going to be back in tempo. Alright, Formula Landing Elix, so my play did not pay out. I think I'll play Lingering Souls. Tazgur not spectacular against two Path to Exiles. So I'm gonna go coast to coast with those spirits. Here I'm going to just play another Lingering Souls. Just hard cast. Hopefully my opponent doesn't have a Rest in Peace, but I don't think he does since he has Path to Exile in his hand. Sorry, Snapcaster Mage in his hand. Okay, so we only know about these three cards. Yeah, I was just about to say, hopefully there's not a Stratocaster, but that's exactly what it is. What now? Awkward position here. Can go Tarmogoyf Scavenging Ooze. I guess with my Scavenging Ooze, I really would like to hit Lightning Elix, but on the other hand, my opponent doesn't have a land to go Snapcaster Lightning Elix. So I'm probably safe in going Scavenging Ooze Tarmogoyf. Though I have time here, I can just eat Helix and Dark Confident and call it a day. Yeah. Let's go with that. I mean, eating Dark Confident is not the best because I have Tazigur, but I really have no interest in casting Tazigur yet because my opponent has just Path of Exile, so I'll slow roll Tazigur a lot, like playing Tazigur exactly with 4 mana up, tapping 1, you know. This is not a card that we keep it now, and I really wanted to use my Green Mana. I guess I could have hit Spell Snare. But let's say I draw Abru Decay, I don't have Abru Decay anymore, but Maestro Impulse, I can go Maestro Impulse to Stratocaster and then attack with the scavenging ooze, or I draw Liliana, you know. If this is a bolt, of course, it's worse than eating his spell snare. Let's see, there's a lot of cards in his hand. Two Pot Exile, one Snapcast. Oh, there's the Rest in Peace. That's kind of bad. Guess I will. Guess I will just activate the Shambling Vents and attack. I mean, is it really bad? I don't think it's that bad. Because, like, yeah, our Thermogriff now is not good. Our Tazigur now overcosted eats our Lingering Souls, which of course are all bad things, but Lingering Souls, we wouldn't have a flashback because my opponent has a Staticaster. Thermogriff would have probably been still that smaller, and I don't know, I guess we can still play Tazigur, so. Okay, so here, my opponent can just flash in. Yeah, I don't see myself winning this game. Don't want to attack because my opponent is just going to go Snapcaster. Oh, and didn't click. Yeah, I guess I will board in. Arbor Decay. Plenty of target for it. I can attack with Shambling Vent, but same reason. Yeah. Let's see if my opponent has the Snapcaster or can even pass the Gazelle Shambly event. I think it's pretty free at this point. Yeah, just let me gain 2 lives, totally fine. Play a 2-2 for 2 Grizzly Bear. Seven cards for my opponent. But here I can finally deal some damage next turn, if nothing happens. Though, still has 2 Path of Exile. That would be very hard to climb. Okay, so Path of Exile news. And I'm gonna get Plains. Still attacking for just gaining 2 life. Nothing real to talk about. I'm gonna lose like 90% this game. You can just concede, yeah. I'm off this game. Oh yeah, it was a match. Yeah, I thought I was winning game 1. Alright then. Just Kai. Just get Goddess. Let's see you next match. We'll be right back.